Day one of this virtual fish leather making workshop. These are our skins. So we've got two sea lamprey skins here. And then on the left here, we have two lake whitefish skins. So it's going to be an exciting week. I'm really excited to learn how to make fish leather.
Perhaps I'm doing too many fish skins, but oh well. This is the northern pike. Gorgeous. The exquisite Arctic char. The burbot is really interesting. It's tiny little scales. The walleye, black crappie. Someone in here, there should be the bass, but I wonder where the bass went. Maybe I lost it down the drain. Anyway.
The first steps are to deflesh and defat the inside of these skins.
Try to go from the head end to the tail end. That's the same direction the scales are going.
So let's start this tanning process. I'm going to take water, salt, and dish detergent, and I'm going to add this, which is oak gallnut extract, which is what's going to do the tanning. I'll be adding the gallnut extract every day, probably for the next 4 days.
So here we are, day two of the workshop, starting to leather off. So you can feel the difference when we're told in the class.
So what is this course we're taking? Well, it is hosted by the Great Lakes St. Lawrence Governors and Premiers, and it's part of their 100% whitefish program. You know, so instead of having waste products from fish, what if we can utilize 100% of those fish? All right, it's day four, and check it out. And you know what I think we have here? I think we have tanned fish skin, which is also called leather. So that's exciting.
I am hoping to turn my fish skins yellow with turmeric and red with beets.
I'm not going to tan your hide. You're my pet.
Some mistakes have been made. I dropped some turmeric dye onto my carpet, and I don't know how I'm ever going to get it out. Check out my product so far. Drying on the board, and now I'm going to put some oil on the back so the leather is pliable.
Right, wrapping up last day here. It is day five of the fish leather workshop. There are my pinned and softened whitefish and sea lamprey, and then this is the yellow dyed lake whitefish. These turned out pretty well. The whitefish is, you know, it's got some good texture to it. The lamprey, a little crinkly, but, you know, I really like the top here, this mottled part, and I think there'll be a use for that. I can do something with this. It's an interesting process. It's, you know, using all this kind of natural and non-toxic stuff means that, hey, anybody can do it. It's, you know, something that I think fish folks can do. It's, you know, lots of opportunities here. So excited to learn about it.